Hi, everyone. Thanks for the calls and texts and checking on me after my other post about the scare I recently had. I wanted to share some new information. And I always said post-leukemia, post-bone marrow transplant, as a journalist, if I can use information that I've gathered and save a life, then I've served my purpose. And so, no, this is not going to be 30 seconds. It's not going to be a 30-second VO for TV. So sorry, honey, but it is going to be some life-saving information and learning through my story. What I've learned from my recent visit at Johns Hopkins, I had to digest it, I left in tears, but there is now new information connecting heart disease with blood disorders or blood cancers, which is one that I had, that's now shedding new light on all the problems that I've been having, many of them in recovery post bone marrow transplant. My doctor says they now believe that there is, in some cases, a familial connection, meaning that it can be passed down through the family through genetic markers. It was enough for him to say that if he had this information 4 years ago, he would have not given me my sister's bone marrow because she has heart disease. My father has heart disease. I didn't have those markers. My dad has polycythemia, a precursor to leukemia. He's had triple bypass. He has a stent. He has a pacemaker. My sister has a heart murmur. And now I have my sister's DNA, which is carrying that. What they said is researchers have been able to identify this genetic marker that if you have it, it's a heart disease genetic marker that says, hey, you are 100% chance of getting heart disease, developing that in time. But now they also know that if you have that same marker, you have an X amount chance, I don't know the percentage yet, I'm still researching, of developing a blood cancer, that you're higher risk. It's good news that they can go now and detect it earlier on. There's a test that's coming out in the next few weeks. I'm in line waiting for it. I hope I can share information so you can get it. But the scary part is for me is they've now given me my sister's DNA. I don't have my DNA and I have her genetic marker for heart disease. And it was really that the light bulb went off. I walked into Johns Hopkins. I've had over the past year, my resting heart rate continues to drop. I'm continuing to have some issues all tied to this, they now believe. And Tuesday, my resting heart rate was 41. And they said, there's a problem. We have got to look into this. And we now feel that this is tied into it. And there's two things they're looking at is, hey, we know that cancer patients are starting to show signs of heart disease and problems because that chemo is so toxic. It's fed directly through a catheter into our heart and your heart has to be strong in order for you to tolerate it. And that's why I was fit. I was able to go through a year of chemo between the actual 10 months of treatment followed by 100 days of bone marrow transplant. So that really worked in my favor, but it's toxic and I'm now paying the price. The second thing is now they're saying, hey, not only did we weaken your heart from the chemo, but now we believe we've given you this genetic marker for heart disease from your sister that's now going to take a toll on your heart as well. And on top of that, we've now possibly put you at a higher risk of developing a blood cancer, blood disorder. No, thank you. Already had that, been there, done that, but now it's too late. The problem is he says he has a patient right now who's in that same situation. He can't, they're not going to give that actual person's genetic markers. They're not going to do the transplant. They're going to pick somebody else. In my case, because I'm mixed race, the donor list is 70% Caucasian. I didn't have another match. They said I would have succumbed to the disease and died. But perhaps they would have tried to even look further out rather than get my sister's. So far, my sister's kept me alive and I'm grateful. But it is shedding some very powerful information. It shows the important, really big importance of research, but also sheds some information about the problems that I'm having, why this is a double whammy. So you might ask what left me in tears as well. What's next for me is tomorrow, my amazing husband, Caesar, is gonna take me to Johns Hopkins. We are lucky enough that I got a chance to meet with, get scheduled with a world-renowned cardiologist who is a specialist in heart failure. And he's very tough to get in. And I got in with him and I will be seeing him tomorrow. We're gonna develop a strategic plan, figure out how I don't go into heart failure, how they can work on my situation, whether I need a pacemaker and what other tests. Then after we get that figured out, I'm gonna have to get a series of other tests. First, they're gonna test my blood, which is really to test my sister because I have her DNA. In order to test my DNA and compare it, they're gonna have to do a skin graft because that's all that's left of my DNA is my skin. Then they'll test my dad's blood. This is something that's gonna happen down the road after we work on my heart. Once they compare all of those and see like what genetic markers did my sister and dad have with heart disease and what was passed on to me And what did I have before or not have? So that's some very valuable information. But really what set me into tears is they said, your son Gabriel now likely has this genetic marker and has a 50-50 chance of having this marker, which would put him at for sure of getting heart disease and a high risk as well as developing a blood cancer, blood disorder. And I don't want my son or anybody for that matter to suffer the way I suffered. So before I go, what does this mean to all of you? This means that there is a blood test that's going to be coming out. I don't know if it's going to be in your area. I'm going to ask more questions and pass it along to you that will help tie in that connection. If you have heart disease in your family, absolutely. If you can get this blood test, look at the genetic marker, then you know what tests you need to start doing to monitor yourself before or if a blood cancer is going to develop for you or someone that you love in your family. I will keep you posted, but this is another reason we all need to armor up. We all need to prehabilitate, prepare, present, prevail. You need to prepare your body for illness so you can present well to doctors and position yourself to prevail, because it is, we all, in the words of my doctors, which was profound, he says, we are all born with the seeds of our own destruction. Right now is the time they're looking at genetic markers so we can help get ahead of that and know what lies ahead for us so we can get ahead and treat ourselves. Thank you and God bless. Have a great day. And don't forget to please armor up.